You know, there were some people who worried that we would finish the Human Genome Project and look at all of the output of this and go, well, yeah, it's kind of what I thought, too. But there were lots of surprises that knocked people's socks off. Perhaps the one that got the most attention and still seems just almost unbelievable is how few genes there actually are in the genome. We talked for the longest time about the 100,000 genes we expected to find. And what do you know? There's only about 20,000. It's amazing that that's enough, but clearly we're all here and the system works. So that gives us great respect for what each one of those genes must be able to do. Another surprise, I think, was to find out that when you look across the genome asking, what's the part that looks like it's been most important simply by comparing it to other species? And we assumed that it would be the protein coding part of the genome. And sure enough, that's very important. But that only accounts for about a third of the most critically functionally important part of our genome. And the other two-thirds, we didn't know about. And there it was, and now it started a whole range of new research projects to try to figure out how that works. And those are telling us a lot that not only just relates to the basic science of how life works, but also how those other sequences, which are regulatory, can affect health and disease.